the
functionality
functionality that I already did and how it's working. So let's see. So basically here the plus icon are there. Whenever we will click on the plus icon, then the pair of means some input element, some input field will be generated dynamically. As you can see, whenever you will click on the plus icon, then automatically the field will be generated. And suppose I am going to type here 444 or any other thing, as depend on you, but I am going to type 444 and here 555. If I delete this second row basically, so it will be deleted successfully. And I am going to type anything so that I can show you the functionality. So let's say I am going to create one more. So I am going to give something, anything, and whenever I will submit the form, we will get the data. So how we will get a data? So you can see here, basically whenever you will click on the submit button, basically submit button, I am giving the primary as for the demo purpose, but you can give a real name. So whenever click on the submit, you will get a data. So form group, we are just returning a form group. So under the section of value, you will get all the value and you can send it to backend, and backend can manipulate this data and maybe store in the database, and whatever they want to do, they will do definitely. So here in the item row, as you can see in the item row, I have a three row are generated. So three row are here also generated, and all the with all the value, whatever value I provided. So this functionality is actually working perfectly fine. So let's discuss and understand each and everything through code. So I come to the component, and here in ng on init, I have, you can see here, I initialized the comp, as you know that in this application I am using form reactive form. Okay, in the reactive form I have created a form builder instance, and you can see here fb is the instance name, and through this we are going to grouping this field, means this form field, and in which you can see here item row. Item row is again going to be a form, means form builder, and array type means in the, it will be dynamically generated. So I have given array, and here we are basically first time we are going to push some array. So here I call a method which is the initial item row. So in the initial item row, I am returning something which is again is going to create a form field, means this form element is going to work in the means we are just generating these things and returning. So I am not thinking that any confusion you have regarding this, because before using reactive form you need to initialize it. So just I initialize, and right now in the form item row is the type of array, and in this initial value is only one array, means one row, and on that row and initial value is, I think you can see here, empty or null, whatever you want to set, just I have set it also, you can also do. And in case of your field is more, then you can also also provide a more input field, more input field, whatever input field you have, so you can give that name also. And that's all. And let's these things are completely done in the component. Let's discuss on the view part in HTML. So basically I as you know that we are using here form control name, and whatever name you have given there, you means at the time of initialization you need to give that name as well. So I have given these things very easy, but in case of array, in case of item row, I have make it form array name, not form control name. Here it is a point, note it down, and it's very important. So form array name, and here you can find from group name. From group name is initially I, it's important, and here I am going to loop it. So add more dot control dot item row, and here control means I did it to access the value of item row. So it is a form of array. So this will be here, the for loop will be run, and all the field will be generated dynamically, means all the row will be generated dynamically, as you know. So that will run, and once it start running, this will be start generating, and their form name are given, as you can see here, initial row. So time range, learn, description and suggestion, I have given the same name, means form control name here. So no doubt on that, just you do this and that's all. And you will find this project link on the description. So GitHub link you will find, and basically I am also going to provide you two separate file link, means only for the this file, means HTML file and component file. And if you will see this code, and easily you will understand, because I am make it very simple to you guys understand very well. So let's discuss here. So I use form control name, and form control name, whatever we given the name there, I just provided here, that's all. And here the action button, means the fourth column is I have written some condition. The condition is that I have given the condition, if condition, if the item row, means whatever item row it is, it's more than, means their length is more than one, then only it will be show minus icon, otherwise that will not show anything. So basically I did these things, so because I want to make it very clear, I want to make the first row should be mandatory for the user, that's why I written these things. This is the condition, otherwise if you not want then it's up to you, but I make it because generally requirement is like that. Then in the footer I have providing the add new row button. So whenever you will click on the add new row, means add button, so the some input field will be dynamically generated, means row will be generated. So I am going to do that one. So here you can see delete row and add row, just see this method in the component. So add new row, basically I use, means form array arr, form arr, what they are doing is to selecting this value item row, and they are providing their value, means they are selecting that one. So they are selected, and I use push method to push some other because in case of add row, so I want to generate one more row, so that's why I have pushed some other array value. So just I am pushing, and this dot initial row, and initial row is returning whatever you want to return, means as per your means requirement, and as per your form. So the first row, means whatever we are generating at the time of beginning, just I provided that one, and that is working perfectly fine. So this is in this way we can generate, and whenever we will modify something, that will be render on the UI, means no need to re-render, automatically that will be updated on the UI. So this is a very cool feature, because two-way data binding is very very better and very beautiful, and out of the box they are providing this functionality and this feature. And this feature is I'm sure that you are also excited once you, means at the time of the learning the Angular, so you are also get excited excited that how it's working, and definitely it's very cool feature. So whenever I will provide these things, means item initial item row, means once we'll push, that will be re-render, that will be updated on the UI, not re-render but updated on the UI due to this functionality. And in a similar way, whenever I want to delete, so particular index that I passed on the component, means in HTML view part, so that will be removed from that you can see here remove at that index. So that in that from that index, that value will be removed from the array, and the final output will be updated on the UI very soon. Means that it's very fast due to two-way data binding. So that's all. And on the submit, just I did console.log and this dot array name, add more. Add more is the my form name, as you can see here. So you also need to give here form group, and their name should be add more. So I have given here add more. So make sure you need to give this, otherwise this functionality is not going to work. This is the basic reactive form thing. So I hope that you understand each and everything very clearly. If still you have any doubt and related to anything in this project, definitely you comment me. Definitely I will try to solve this problem, because now I don't have any crowd on my YouTube channel. So definitely I will reply on you guys, and definitely I will help, and I will feel very better if I will help someone. So I hope that you are enjoying this video. So let's go and sleep and do what